Hi, we haven't seen any Japanese Hayoki brand equipment on the EEV blog before, so I thought it'd be interesting to take a look at it. These were sent in by Hayoki through their US agent, tequipment.net, who you might know, so thank you very much. Yes, made in Japan, all the best stuff's made in Japan, according to Marty McFly. So I thought we'd take a look at these, primarily the multimeter. I'm not really into big current AC clamp stuff. This is like 4200 amp. You know, clamp type meter, but we'll do a simple tear down of that. I'm a bit more interested in the multimeter. This is not an electronics, what I don't call an electronics industry multimeter. It's an electrical multimeter. That's because it doesn't have like microamp range and the capacitance doesn't go down low enough and other stuff like that. But anyway, I thought we'd take a look at it. Could be interesting. Let's go. Optional comms, which I don't think they give, but hey, drop proof, dual display, and supposed to be fast and all that sort of stuff. Let's check it out. And that's what we get in the box. It's blue. All the best stuff comes in blue. Let's check that out. It's not quite EEV blog blue, but it's blue nonetheless. I don't know about the purple hold button there. That's a bit of an unusual choice. But anyway, that looks and feels quite neat. Well, let's give it a twist test. Actually, that's not the best I've felt. Range switch feels okay. Positive detents on that. Looks like we've got four AAA batteries. Jeez, I'd want to get good battery life. And the probes look and feel really nice. Yes, flexible silicone insulation on them. Not the sharpest tool in the shed, but yeah, it does the job. Gold-plated, Hayoki-branded probes, and they do have the slip-on Cat 4 thingamabob. And Underwriters Lab-listed cable. Thank you very much. And you know what we say here on the EEV blog? Don't turn it on. Take it apart. That looks like a sensor. Like ambient light sensor or something? Or is it a LED? It could be like a high voltage LED. I don't know. Read the manual. RTFM. Speaking of which, the manual is all in English and look at that. It's thick as. And it looks really quite jazzy. It's got all the requisite diagrams. Oh, look at that. AC frequency response. Oh, that's the filter. Hence why it's got a filter button on the front there, which is rather interesting. That's just the variable frequency, you know, the typical 1 kilohertz thing, 4 to 20 milliamps. Nice manual. They've gone to town on that. Let's have a quick look at the back of it. There's our infrared comms serial interface. That just plugs in there. IR LEDs, very typical. Single screw. Hopefully the battery compartment just comes out. Anyway, we are talking HRC fuses on both of those ranges, as you'd expect for a quality brand, you know, Cat 4 rated meter. No worries. What's under the hood? Four AA batteries, just the one big HRC fuse there, 11 amps. That's only for their, they do milliamps on that as well. Obviously, if they had microamps range, then they'd have to do that with only the three jacks. They'd have to almost certainly do it through there and require another fuse on that. But nope, just there. Unfortunately, it doesn't have microamps. So to my mind, it's not usable as an, well, it's usable as an electronics meter. It just doesn't have your typical electronics meter microamp functionality. And there's nice deep grooves around the side of that, so that should protect it. It's all in its own little enclosure there, the big HRC fuse. So if that releases the magic smoke, then it shouldn't do too much other damage. So that's very nice. And of course, a machine threaded screw, as you'd expect. None of that self-tapping rubbish. Like I showed before, you get the holster comes off really well. It is quite thin and compact and lightweight without the batteries in it, but it does, I'm not sure if you see that, but I can feel it. There is quite, you know, a little bit of flex in that. Although this, you know, once you put it in the holster, I have no doubt it's going to survive its 1 meter drop on the concrete. It's just not the, it's not the most stable case I've seen. All right, screws are out. Yes, they are self-tappers, but that's fine because you never have to get into the thing. Oh, come on. Oh, hang on. Oh, must have a bloody clip somewhere. Nope, stupid me has to take the fuse out because they've got the plastic under there. That's actually, that's not bad at all. I think that's the first time I've seen that. All right, one more time for the dummies. Let's lift that off. And we're in like Flynn, no wires going over to any buzzer or anything like that. Oh, I like the look at the dual. First thing I noticed was the dual wipes on the battery contact. That is probably the best battery to PCB implementation I've seen. Big thumbs up for that. I'm very, very impressed. Wow, and nice big pads. Oh, it's all happening. That looks neat and tidy, doesn't it? Look at the input jacks. Geez, they're pretty good. Held down with, they would be metal threaded inserts inside there, and going down to both sides, four solder points. Looks very robust. We've got ourselves the high voltage isolation slots here. Very nice between the separate one over here and the two different input paths here. And from the fuse, wow, they know what they're doing. That is really very neat and tidy. I'm very impressed with that. Now, at first I thought this glass job here must be like a gas discharge tube or something like that. But get it under the macro lens and you can see there's a couple of little contacts either side with what looks like a ceramic type substrate in there. Wow! I don't think I've ever seen that before. It's very unusual. What's going on there? Wow, look at that! Yeah, I think it's still some form of gas discharge tube, GDT type thing, but it's using some ceramic former in there, and those black dots look like, you know, maybe a staged breakdown or something, and maybe, you know, like a controlled breakdown discharge tube or something like that. Wow, that is neat. That's a first. And the best part number I can get off that is CSB242M. So yeah, like, you know, you Google that and you get like little fuse GDTs and stuff like that. But no, I can't find the exact one. If I can, I'll edit it in. But anyway, yes, it is open. So it's some form of, you know, high-arcing GDT thing. Anyway, check out the beautiful guard tracing going back here to protect against surface leakage on the PCB. The center trace there is what they're guarding against. Very nice. The designers knew what they were doing here. There's our current shunt resistor, 10 milliohms, R010 is the dead giveaway there. That'd be our current front end. And that job there is the 74HC4052. I love it that, you know, even these days, like just jelly bean, for, you know, 74HC4000 series type switching logic is still used. Wow. Geez, check out all the diode array there. They must be doing that for range switching. And under the shielded hood there, there's our Hioki branded chipset, the HAZ0105. I doubt they're spinning their own, but hey, I could be wrong. So it could be like a rebadged one of, you know, three main multimeter chipset manufacturers in there. And there's our two, there's our LED and our photo receiver there. And ta-da, for all you MSP 430 fanboys, there you go. So it should be reasonably low power. MSP 430, the choice of low power champions there. That'd be our programming interface for that. There's our little surface mount buzzer, and not a huge amount more around there, really. So that's about all she wrote. So that is certainly a very well designed, neat and tidy, well manufactured bit of kit. Thumbs up. And check out the really deep grooves they've got on there for blast protection around the outside. Yep, they're doing everything right. Fantastic. So as far as input protection goes, they haven't really gone overboard there. They've got the one PTC in series here, and they've got the one gas discharge tube, but that's it, no MOVs. But a GDT is exactly, and it performs the same function as a MOV. In fact, that looks like a really schmick, expensive jobby. But hey, you know, it's, I'm sure it is, no doubt meets the latest IEC, you know, Cat 4 standard for this. If you have a look at the general specs here, they don't really tell you anything about that. It just says safety. It meets EN61010, which is, it doesn't say what version of the standard, doesn't say whether it's independently UL tested or anything like that. So, I mean, Hioki make quality bits of kit, so I'm sure it's more than capable, but yeah, there's no independent testing labels at all. And that goes for the back too. There's nothing there. And for all you mode labeling fanboys, there you go. APS off, buzzer off, and auto backlight you can disable. Is it my imagination, or are they all helter-skelter? They're, like, not lined up. They're all angled. Not sure what's going on there. What the? Anyway, nice to be able to disable the backlight. And for those who desperately want to see the bottom, we've got another high-voltage resistor string there, but that's about all she wrote. But that little thing on the front panel was either an ambient light sensor or a LED. I'm sure it's a LED. It's, it'll be to do with the voltage detection. Okay, so when the voltage detection thing does its business, then, it'll light up and flash the LED. And the range switch looks like a pretty standard implementation with the little knobbly things on the side which go into the indents there. That should work a treat. Should be pretty reliable. And the tilting bail on it, nice and wide at the bottom, does the business, doesn't fall over when you push the buttons. Yeah, once again, I can't help but feel, I mean, see if you can hear this. Here we go. You can just hear it, you know, like, it just does not feel like a brick, you know, which is what I want an industrial electrical multimeter to feel like. So I'm going to say that's, you know, the case is unfortunately quite flimsy, which is a shame, because it's otherwise brilliantly design and manufactured. But yeah, just a bit of a fail there. And unfortunately the LCD isn't the best contrast or the biggest. I mean, it's a dual display, so you know, it's going to have a smaller display, of course. I mean, the EV log meter, that's as big as digits get on meters, basically. So not so much the size, but yeah, just the contrast isn't terrific. But high up, it does the job at high angles though. And as far as backlights go, it's barely even noticeable. And if I turn the lights completely off, yeah, it's probably gonna do the business, but it's certainly not bright. Probably the weakest one I've seen, I think. Anyway, we switch it on, and dual display, of course, in AC mode, it's going to display the frequency up there. Got a nice little bar graph up there for the battery. That kind of makes me concerned about what the battery life is if it has to have a bar graph. And it's actually in the specs. I like how they tell you what it actually goes down to. It's 1 volt per cell, because there's 4 AAA cells in there. So you're using up, you know, a good majority of the capacity in the batteries before it starts blinking. Now, I like how it actually tells you the voltages in here. And it completes power shutdown at 4 volts, but it doesn't really tell you, it's going to be blinking at you from 4 to 4.5. Presumably, it's going to still meet its specs at the low voltage. So you get down to 1 volt per cell. So that's good. That's using, you know, a good majority of the energy in your AAA batteries. But unfortunately, continuous operating time, 130 hours with backlight off. No, that's not what you want from 4 AAAs. You want a couple of hundred hours. I don't like it. And it's good enough, but it's not, it's not in the better class of meters, that's for sure. And whoa, yeah, 6 milliamps, you know, that's, okay, that's reasonable, but yeah, it's just, like, on a non-data logging, non-high functionality type meter, it's probably a bit too high for AAAs. Check this out, I really like that it's got a separate continuity switch position. No touching the buttons or any rubbish like that. Let's see how quick it is. Whoa. Oh yeah, that is latching and instant. That's one of the best there is. Check this out, it's also got visual alert. Why can't they latch that? Why can't they, like, as soon as it buzzes, they should latch that rather than just have it continuously on. They've gone to the effort to do that, but they haven't gilded the lily. I want my lily gilded, please. Auto ranging response. That was quick. Oh, I don't like the beeping. But doesn't have an option to disable that? I find that really annoying, but geez, that's damn quick auto ranging. Nice. And check this out. If you turn the min-max, turn it to average mode like this, just keeps beeping at you that it's like, what? Give me a break. That is going to a new average. Oh, geez. Lucky you can switch that off. But check this out. I do like how the secondary display actually displays the live reading and the primary display displays your min, max, and average. That's a real nice implementation. Thumbs up for that. Unfortunately, if you turn that beeper off by holding filter when you power it on, sure enough, it goes away. Okay, look, it's fine. It's now silent. But your continuity buzzer doesn't work. No, fail. Like, no. You always want your continuity buzzer to work. Like, no. And another reason why this isn't an electronics class meter, as I would define it, doesn't have a low capacitance range. The minimum is the 1 microfarad range. Oh, I've got to plug it in the right way. Well, these electrons will fall out. And there's my 10 nanofarad reference cap. And sure enough, but yeah, it's only designed for electrical applications, large motor, you know, run motor start capacitors, large values, things like that. So it's good enough for its purpose. It's just not an electronics class meter that can measure puff. And this is pretty disappointing. Diode test range, 1.5 volts maximum for your four AA batteries. Four of them, and they can only do 1.5 volts max, so that won't even light up a red LED. So yeah. Disappointing. And the lowest current measurement range, 60 milliamps. And well, that's fine for electrical stuff. Once again, electronic stuff, yeah, not good enough. And by the way, yes, this is a 6,000 count meter, 6,000 count primary and secondary. And the specs aren't going to set the world on fire. Typical 0.3 volts, that's, you know, good enough for a 6,000 count instrument of this class, plus minus 5 digits. You got to read the numbers anyway for the different models. Oh, it's a bit tighter for the model we've got, I think, the 42, 53, 56. Yeah, I like a tighter spec meter. Plus minus 3 digits for our particular model in your typical 10 mega ohm input impedance. But yeah, it's an electrical class meter. Not going to set the world on fire spec-wise. And the low Z mode here, there you go, it's got low Z up there. It's just on like 900-odd K down at the, 1.5 volts test voltage or whatever. That's going to decrease, of course, when you increase the voltage. But some meters, like the BM235, don't switch on at all, and they give you 10 meg, anything below 8 volts or something like that. So, yeah, anyway, low Z mode. It's going to work a treat. Unfortunately, no input warning jack alert when I plug it into amps. You saw that in the teardown when we have it in voltage mode. So that's something you want in an electrical meter. So that's a disappointing oversight. And it's bang on spec on the voltage. No worries there. Oh, yeah, yep, that's good enough. And yep, it doesn't overshoot. Switches very nicely to the exact reading. Nice. And it's bang on current too. No worries. And bang on resistance too. So there you go, that's the Hioki DT4256 electrical digital multimeter, and it's designed and built quite well. The only issues I had with it, you know, lack of little stuff like input jack alert, things like that, that annoying beep thing, and when you disable it, the continuity tester goes off. But it's fast and accurate, does the business, but yeah, in that case, it's just not the most robust thing around. But yeah, designed and made very well by the looks of it. Not sure, and of course, the certification and all that, not independently certified, or not that I can tell anyway. So T Equipment have this for, listed at $199, but it's on clearance special for $159 or something. That's US Yankee dollars, of course. So it's a reasonable value for a top brand meter made in Japan. So yeah, it's quality. It's just not as robust as it could be, but and a few little things, but it's going to do the business. Battery life, not great, but it's not embarrassing either. So that's not a bad attempt at an electrical class meter. It's probably going to serve you quite well, definitely compared to the cheapies, that's for sure. Whether or not it's good value in this range, I don't know. I haven't surveyed the electrical class range meters and stuff like that. I don't know. But if you've got a comment on this, whether or not you think it's good value, because it's certainly designed and produced quite well, leave it in the comments down below. All right, now we've got the Hayoki 3280-70F clamp meter. I wonder if it comes with both types of clamps. I rather like the flexible clamps like that. Anyway, this is like for big stuff. This is like 4200 amps. Thank you very much. But it's got multimeter functionality in there with the separate probes. So here we go. We've got ourselves a manual, thick as, but it's got all of the languages. Oh, anyway, ooh, that's smooth. Silky smooth. Let's open this puppy up. Oh, that's slim as. Wow, I like the slimness of that. Let's give that a twist test. Yeah, like there's no like holster or anything. Don't know if it's supposed to be drop proof. Is it? I think, yeah, drop proof. I assume like the 1 meter drop, I don't know, or straight onto the plastic or onto the clamps. I don't know, but clamp meters are vulnerable in that respect. But geez, I like how thin that is. That's really quite jazzy. You could almost slip that in a, if you had a pocket big enough. Not quite sure about that. Anyway, it's got like thumb rotating switch thing. Oh, sorry, I turned it on before I took it apart. But that's current, and then AC voltage, and then DC voltage. It's Cat 3, 300 volts, Cat 2, 600 volts, which is not really what you want in a an industrial meter that goes up to like, you know, 1,000 amps or whatever. You want sort of like Cat 4 type stuff, don't you? But I guess in this sort of form factor, you're not going to get that. Oh, look at that. Doesn't have standard. Banana jacks on the bottom. Ooh. And sure enough, the probes, once again, nice silicone leads on them. No worries whatsoever. But I've got to call that a fail for a custom lead interface. Your leads bust, you lose them, whatever, and they're not, they go in there, okay? But geez, I don't know, it almost feels like a pocket clamp meter, like not a proper, you know, not a proper real big man rugged meter. So let's do the continuity mode. Nah, slow as a wet week. Nope. Nope, fail. And looks like it runs off a single CR2032 battery. That's nice. Draws 15 milliwatts. So what's that? What's the battery life of that? I'll pop up a curve somewhere here, I'm sure. And you bet we get the flexi probe with it. Beauty. That's up to 4200 amps because the main one here is only up to 1000 amps AC. But Cat 4 rated 300 volts. And like it's got CE, but no like independent, type approvals on this. No independent testing. Hayoki, I don't know, you know, why they're not going to be doing that. Maybe they think, oh, their own one is enough, and maybe it is, but it's always nice to see, you know, independent UL or other type approval. Anyway, that plugs in like that. No worries. And this just pulls out. You don't have to twist it or anything like that. I believe it's got a magnet in there because it kind of sort of sucks it in and holds it quite well. Rather like that implementation. Anyway, you just fold that around the cable you want to test and Bob's your uncle. But of course, the problem here is that this is an AC clamp probe only, so not designed for DC, so it's not going to use that Hall effect sensor in there. So unfortunately, it's for AC only. It's a specific purpose. It's designed for a purpose. So if you need like a real thin, simple, AC clamp meter, then it's going to do the business. But apart from that, no, it's not, you know, it's not DC and it doesn't have standard banana jacks or anything like that. And the continuity test is pretty meh on it. And well, yeah, designed for a job. Of course, I should have seen that on the box. AC clamp meter. You know exactly what you're buying. So, you know, I'll just show you the difference in thickness between the Fluke AC Wireless 3000 FC current clamp and this one. Huge difference there. Once again, this is an AC only current clamp, and yeah, this one's just tiny and lightweight compared to this thing. All right, here we go. We've got four self-tapping screws on there. I like the little holder down in there. Oh, yep, no cables. There we go. We're in like Flynn. Once again, Hayoki chipset, or Hayoki branded chipset. It could be using an off-the-shelf. Oh, We've got that GDT again. Yep, we've got the exact same CSB242M, I believe it is. It's hard to see the numbers on there, but yeah, exactly the same. Oh, the through-hole ceramic cap just bent on the side there. It's a bit low rent. Didn't really expect that. And they haven't gone to the effort to, you know, like make these PCB mountable or anything like that. They've just sort of wired them over. Granted, they've put little bits of insulation on there. You know, neat touch. But yeah, I'm not going to write home to my mother about it. Is that a 32 kilohertz watch crystal in there? Low power. This doesn't need to have fast update in all the rest of it. So maybe they are operating the chipset at 32.768 kilohertz. Who knows? Or it could have its own faster internal oscillator, but there'd be no reason for a real-time clock in something like this. Oh, is that a trimmer? Oh, I didn't want to see a trimmer in there. Gee, oh, there's another one! Ah, trimmers all over the place. So as far as the multimeter side of this thing goes, you know, they've got the GDT in there, gas discharge tube for the overload, stuff like that, but no PTCs. You know, they've got the three high voltage input resistors, this high voltage input resistor here, but that's about it. You know, typical pocket multimeter type stuff. Nothing wrong with that. It's just is what it is. So yeah, there's really nothing else to see in there apart from that, which is kind of fun. I don't know. I would have liked it. You know, the solder's wired directly on the board. I don't know. Is it better to have a connector? Yeah, it would have been a nice touch, but I don't know. Yeah, it's reasonably neat and tidy. You know, it's reasonable for its functional for its purpose, I guess. So, yeah, there you go. That's inside the Hiokey 3280 10F little almost pocket-like AC clamp meter. It's probably as small as you can make a clamp meter, I think, you know, with external inputs. That's probably as small as you wouldn't want to see it made much smaller, really. But, you know, it's probably going to do the job. So, yeah, I wouldn't go using, like, the multimeter functionality of this in, like, industrial applications. But it's probably just, you know, designed as, oh, it's got a handy little multimeter extra plug-in. You know, it's only Cat 3, 300 volts. But, hey, there's no current capability in this thing, which is exactly what you'd expect. So no worries there. So you don't have to worry about, you know, that sort of functionality. You just got to worry about, you know, over-voltage surges and things like that. So, yeah, I don't know. But as an AC clamp meter, sure, it works quite well. I'm not going to bother to go hook it up to AC wires and measure it. I don't know. Have a look at the specs. Sure, it meets it. It's a proper brand, Hiokey. It's going to do the business. What is it? AC? Oh, yeah. 1.5 digits, minimum range, 42 amps. It's not my kettle of fish, but hey, for those in the AC, large current AC clamp field, it's probably not a bad pocket one. Are there any others this thin? I don't know. I don't know the market. Anyone? Bueller? So there you go. That's a quick look at two bits of Japanese kit. An electrical multimeter and a pocket AC clamp meter. And they'd hold up reasonably well. Yeah, just a few little minor issues. They seem to do a reasonably respectable job for what they're designed for. So if you like the video, please give it a big thumbs up. If you like review videos, I do have a plan at the moment to get more into product review videos. So if you want more product review videos, definitely give it a big thumbs up. Leave it in the comments down below. And we'll see what we can do. Maybe I'll discuss it on the forum of what my plans are and things like that. Anyway, catch you next time.